A lot of people are going to look at the box score and see how well Manuel scored, but what the box score won't say is...
five, and it's going to be Bradley's toughest test probably of the season here and at Tulsa. You mentioned the 23-game home winning streak. Tulsa's got a five-game winning streak as well. One of those is going to end tonight.
Meanwhile, Jim Les, we have a classic contrast here tonight, a team that likes to run and one that hates to do it.
Two different styles, and I think the team that can run the style that they want to run is going to win tonight. Tulsa more deliberate. They're going to run when they have the break, but they more or less want to come up, set up, and run their offense, whereas Bradley, as we know, wants to run down, get the first available good shot. Whoever can control that tempo could win tonight.
Well, we're going to grab a chair for this one. We hope you're comfortable in yours, and we'll have the starting lineups for you in just a minute.
Eradicating herbicide and saving money. Meet Dale Kennedy.
I saved about $3 an acre and got better performance than with Dual. You can see the good control.
Here's Ree Jensen. Eradicating gave me better control than Lasso for $3 an acre less.
Eradicating users are getting better grass control at a better price than Dual or Lasso.
Here's Dennis Rumar.
Eradicating did the job on my foxtail and cost $2.50 an acre less than Lasso.
You'll save when you switch to Eradicating.
He's right, you know. Brad Nussbaum. How are you?
Now at Cohen's, this 25-inch RCA color console with remote control. RCA's XL100 color television with channel lock digital remote control, on-screen channel display, the latest cable-ready 1987 model. On sale at an unbeatable $499. You save $200 on an RCA color console with remote control. An unbeatable value from Cohen's.
Presents something soft for everyone who's having a hard day. It's our new soft taco, real cheddar cheese, crisp lettuce, and seasoned ground beef wrapped in a soft flour tortilla. So if you've had a hard day at the office, remember, eat softly and carry a big stick. The new soft taco, another great tasting taco from Taco Bell.
Try our new soft shell taco at Taco Bell in Peoria, Pekin, and Normal.
Put your sleep problems to rest forever. Next Donahue.
Only one Missouri Valley team beat the Braves last year, and Tulsa was that team in the Missouri Valley Conference Tournament in Tulsa, Oklahoma. A game in which the Braves came in with a 22-game win streak. And tonight, it's Tulsa that has the streak, as Lee Hall mentioned, a five-game winning streak, and they also have first place in the Missouri Valley. They're 4-0 so far this year. A win for Bradley tonight would tie them for first place, not only with Tulsa, but also with idle Wichita State. The Shockers don't play tonight. In fact, Tulsa and Bradley are the only two teams that play in the Missouri Valley tonight.
When I talked to Coach J.D. Barnett of Tulsa yesterday, I asked him what his Hurricanes have been doing well in that five-game winning streak in all season, and he said playing defense, and that's it. They haven't been shooting the ball too well. He said they can't roll the ball in the ocean. They've been playing so poorly. They shot about 40% against USC the other day, and they've been shooting 50% in the Missouri Valley, so they have picked it up a little bit. It's interesting. Tracy Moore has been struggling offensively for them as well.
And Jim, defense is J.D. Barnett's forte. He took a team that was known as an offensive powerhouse when Nolan Richardson was here, and he changed them into a defensive team, and they had one of the best defensive clubs in the nation last year, and you were sort of the victim of that defense in that Missouri Valley tournament, weren't you?
Well, Tulsa's known for coming out and playing tough physical defense, and you know, tonight with Hawk, they're going to come out and really bump him, bruise him, you know, maybe waste a few fouls just trying to take him out of his game. And I think it's important for Hawk at the start not to get frustrated. You know, maybe he might not be getting his shots, he might be getting hacked, and he may not get the fouls called. But he's just got to keep plugging away because he's very important in Bradley's scheme of things.
Well, there you see the results of a year ago. In the regular season, the Braves winning twice by scores of 71-58 and 54-51, and then losing in the Missouri Valley Conference Tournament Championship game 74-58, and that was on Tulsa's home floor. The Braves come in with a record of 9-8. They are 3-1 in the Valley, and Tulsa with a record of 14-3. They are unbeaten in the Valley with a record of 4-0. Here are the starting lineups for Tulsa, a 6'7 senior, 195 pounds, number 23, David Moss. He had 23 points against USC on Saturday and 25 the game before that versus Illinois State, so he's coming off a big week. For the Braves, number 40, 6'7 junior, Trevor Trimpe, averaging 5.5 points and 5 rebounds a game. He's back on the front line where he feels more comfortable since Anthony Manuel's played the point so much better. For Tulsa, number 33, Jeff Riley, a 6'9 senior, averaging only 4 points a game. His brother Brian is the leading rebounder on the club, but he's not starting tonight because of the flu. For the Braves, number 32, 6'5 junior, Greg Jones, making his fifth consecutive start. 7.8 points and 5.4 rebounds per game, and he's done a good job helping on the boards with Luke Jackson. At center, number 31, 6'7 junior, Donald Royster. He was a high school teammate of David Moss, and he is the second center that Tulsa has used this year. Luke Jackson, 6'8 freshman from Webb, Mississippi, by way of Springfield, starting at center for the Braves, averaging 6.5 points and 6.8 rebounds. For Tulsa, number 21, the point guard, 6'3 senior Byron Boudreaux, had 12 assists on Saturday against USC, and he's the all-time leader in that department for the Tulsa Golden Hurricane. At the point for the Braves, number 12, Anthony Manuel, the sophomore from Chicago, who has really picked up this ball club since playing so well at ISU and then against Creighton the other night. The other guard for Tulsa, the 6'4 junior, Tracy Moore. He's the leading scorer on this team at 16.6 a game. He's only scored 12 points in the last two games combined, though. And Hersey Hawkins, the 6'3 junior, starts at the other backcourt spot for the Braves, averaging 25.5 points per game. We'll be back with the opening tip-off right after this.
Now, for a limited time only, get an incredible 80% discount on all in-stock cars and trucks at University Ford, Peoria's only 5-star Ford dealer. That's right, for 3 days only, get an 80% discount when you buy your new car or truck at University Ford. Stop in our showroom or meet us at the car show, January 29th through the 31st at Northridge Mall. Get the facts and save an incredible 80% on your next car or truck while they last. University Ford, Peoria's only 5-star Ford dealer. 3403 North University, Peoria.
Oh, hi, Sandy, it's me. No, I'm at home. The surgery? It was fine. Registering was a breeze, and the nurses were so nice. Why, before I knew it, I was on my way home. And guess what? It didn't cost nearly as much as an overnight stay in the hospital. Would I do it again? Definitely. Outpatient surgery at Methodist is just the greatest. Because now I'm home.
Outpatient surgery at Methodist. Because there's no place like home to recover.
Today, weekdays at 7 on WEEK.
Bradley coming off a victory over Creighton, 95-67, and Tulsa winning its last game out at USC on Saturday.
One matchup we want to really keep an eye on is Anthony Manuel guarding Byron Boudreaux. Anthony's played so well in the last couple of games against ISU. He had 19 points, and he's had 18 assists in the last two games. If he can do the defensive job on Boudreaux that he did against Jeff Harris, I think Bradley's going to have a good chance. There's a couple of other interesting matchups here tonight.
Well, Tulsa's got their M&M boys with Moore and Moss, and I think Trevor's going to guard David Moss, and we'll see Hawk on Tracy Moore. Two key matchups, you know. Hawk is going to have to guard Moore tough, but he can't get in foul trouble. He's too valuable to Bradley. So that's going to be an interesting matchup the fans should watch.
Bradley trying to earn a share of first place in the Missouri Valley Conference. Luke Jackson to tip it up against Donald Royster. And it is Jeff Riley who has the ball in Tulsa with control of it. There's Byron Boudreaux matched up with Anthony Manuel. Now Boudreaux pounds the dribble in front of the Bradley bench. Manuel all over him to Royster inside. The ball knocked away, and here goes Trevor Trimpe all by his lonesome to Hawk. And the Braves score first blood. Here's that matchup Jim Les talked about, Boudreaux against Manuel. To David Moss, he's guarded by Trimpe. Tracy Moore with it. Picked up by Hawkins. No shot. This is Moore in front of the Bradley bench. Pounds the dribble. Looks to set the screen. Shoots and misses. And Luke Jackson is there with a rebound. Manuel holds it high, top of the circle to Hawkins for the jumper. And he scored the Braves' first 4 points.
Hawk is off to a good start, and that's a good sign for Bradley fans. Coach Albeck put in a new offense. He's getting a lot of screens for Hawk to free him.
Inside Royster with a turnaround, rolls no good, and Jones is there to rip it down. Manuel up the floor. And a whistle, and Ed Schumer says he double dribbled. Our officials tonight, Ed Schumer, who made that call, Ron Zetcher, and Rich Eichhorst.
Jimmy, you talked earlier about the Braves controlling the boards and getting down the floor. If they can get down there and beat that matchup, that's exactly what they want to do, because if they can beat that matchup, they can score.
Royster with no shot, attempts to move around Jackson, can't, and then his pass is stripped away by Greg Jones. Braves leading 4-0, a minute and change into the ballgame. This is Luke Jackson, double team, nowhere to go. He throws it off the hands of a Tulsa player, and they say that Jackson touched it last, so the Golden Hurricane will take over.
You know, we talked about tempo earlier in the game, and Coach Albeck feels that if Bradley can play a good, solid man-to-man defense and get turnovers like they're doing now, or force Tulsa into bad shots, they can control the tempo and get out and run.
Seeing a lot of good help on the inside. Greg on the last play. Trevor knocked the ball away earlier on that break.
This is Moss. Long pass to Trippi. Pulls up, tried to draw the foul. Doesn't score. Jackson on the rebound. Goes up in the crowd. And misses. And then a whistle after the play on Greg Jones. And look at Greg Jones. He wants Jeff Riley. Jeff Riley did not play the first half of the season. He sat out the first semester. He was academically ineligible.
When you looked at Jeff Riley, just by looking at him, he looks like Bob the Hammer Fleming. And that's about the way he plays, too. He's a tough guy. He's in there to push people around, get a rebound. He's not what you'd call a finesse player, I don't think.
I think Greg Jones wants a share of the belt.
Braves trying to work that trap. Tulsa works at the front court. And Boudreaux has it top of the circle. Off to Moss, guarded by Trippi. Now works at baseline, nowhere to go. Trippi nearly pulls off the steal, and then Greg Jones does. Here come the Braves, leading 4-0. The Braves applying tremendous pressure in the Tulsa backcourt. Byron Boudreaux calls play number 3. This is Boudreaux into the lane. Looks for a cutter and throws the ball away. And again, Greg Jones is there to scoop up the garbage. That's the third time that he has come up with a turnover. Braves 4-0 over Tulsa. 16:40 to play in the first half. Trippi with the ball. Now to Manuel. Here's the Hawk. And he has all 6 points that have been scored in the game. And everyone still on their feet here at Carver Arena, where the Braves have won 23 in a row. Tracy Moore looking to break that shutout. Bounces to Moss, who kicked the ball, no call. Goes up in a crowd and hits. And the shutout is finally broken.
Offensively, the fans should watch Hawk. He's running off two or three screens every time down. That's why he's been able to get free for these jumpers. Here he goes off loop.
Out to Trippi, now to Manuel. Had the shot, doesn't take it. Inside Jackson. Turnaround jump, no good. Rebound, Donald Royster. Anthony Bobbs was the center for Tulsa when the season began. But he's been dropped from the team, and Royster's taken over the pivot. Here's Moss off the side of the iron. Rebound battled for. Jeff Riley with it. Rainbow shot, no good. And Jones is there to collect the carry to Anthony Manuel at the foul line. Hawkins, a three-pointer. And Percy Hawkins has all 9 points. The Braves have scored. They're up 9-2.
I think Hawks got it on automatic tonight.
You talked to J.D. Barnett, we talked to him yesterday, and the first thing he mentioned, you got to worry about Hawkins. He's either going to score the points or penetrate and pass off. Of course, everybody worries about Hawkins, or they should.
Hawkins on the block. Nice pass to Trippi. Shoots and hits. Bradley 11, Tulsa 2, and J.D. Barnett jumps up off the bench and says, boys,
maximum performance, weatherproof your corn soil insecticide. Use Counter in furrow. Your protection won't be scattered by wind during application. And it's protected from heavy rains, so you put all of your insecticide to work in the soil. And Counter, with its unique Action 3, controls more major corn pests than any other insecticide. For superior control and proven performance, put your money where your crop is. Counter in furrow.
With George sick, I've had a lot on my mind. Thank goodness WeCare 65 helped me sort out all the Medicare red tape. The WeCare 65 representative explained the Medicare rules and helped me file insurance claims. Methodist even had a hotline to answer our questions and special classes on diet, exercise, and medication just for older adults like us. You know, I think Methodist really had us in mind when they set up WeCare 65.
Every year, the farmers who grow Coors barley get together with someone from Coors to celebrate. And when I say someone from Coors, I mean someone named Coors. You see, these families and the Coors family have been working out here together for generations, growing barley that's different, special, easy drinking, never bitter. Hey, this is where it all starts. For Coors, that's worth celebrating.
High Society on the next Oprah Winfrey Show.
There are the three gentlemen that are calling the shots tonight. Ron Setcher, Egg Schumer, and Rich Eichhorst. So far, J.D. Barnett's called shots, and Tulsa hasn't followed the script.
Well, you know, I came out saying that Tulsa would be deliberate. I think you can call me a liar. And I think the reason they're down 9 points this early is they're coming down taking quick shots or not handling the ball very well, and that's not J.D. Barnett's style. So I think he called the timeout and yelled in their ears a little bit, make them remember that, hey, this is Tulsa, we played deliberate, we're going to work for good shots.
Bradley's man-to-man is so tough inside, they're helping out so well. That might be part of their problem, too. They just feel rushed.
Brian Riley now into the ballgame for the first time, passes to brother Jeff, and it's batted out of bounds by Greg Jones. Brian Riley woke up today with the flu, and life on the road has been no fun for him. Before the USC game on Saturday, he got stuck in the hotel elevator for 3 hours, nearly didn't make it to the game.
I think that was a ploy. He didn't want to leave Southern California.
Boudreaux on the miss. Manuel fights for the rebound. Luke Jackson comes up with it. And the Bradley coaching staff complaining that Anthony Manuel was fouled. The Braves worked the ball up the floor, and Manuel limps his way up the floor, and we finally get a timeout from Ron Zetcher.
The hammer makes his presence known early.
That was Jeff Riley who did the damage on Manuel. And now Stan Albeck making sure that the officials don't miss it next time. Here it is for you if you missed it the first time. Looks like Lawrence Taylor on Joe Theismann there, doesn't it?
Or Bob Fleming on any IHL guy you want to name. Going into the boards the hard way, I guess.
Bradley 11, Tulsa 2, 14:20 left to go in the first half. The Braves with a win would grab a share of first place in the Valley.
Tulsa's going to a 1-2-2 zone right now.
This is Trimpy, top of the circle, a three-pointer. And the Braves have opened up a 14-2 lead. Trevor Trimpy with 5 points. Here's Moore all the way to the basket. His first 2 points of the game.
We talked about that help, and there wasn't much that one once he blew by his man.
Those got to be conscious of getting back on defense. Tulsa will take the break if it's there.
Greg Jones on the turnaround, works it by Brian Riley and scores, and it's now a 16-4 ball game. Incidentally, Hersey Hawkins has made all four of his field goal attempts. Here's Jeff Riley. Doesn't do much with the ball. He's better without it. Here's Manuel. Dishes it off to Greg Jones. Will the basket count? The foul's on Boudreaux. And Ed Schumer says,
I don't think so.
No basket.
Anthony did a good job of waiting for his teammates to come down with him. He had to hold up and wait for Greg and Luke to catch up with him. And you saw Byron Boudreaux with a block in the lane.
And it was before the shot, so the basket won't count. The Blazers are inbound, and they do to Greg Jones.
Stay off, now.
Here's Manuel. Up top, Percy Hawkins, now to Trippi, back to Manuel. Cut, 13 minutes to play in the half. Trippi eyed the shot, doesn't take it. Finds Jones, and Brian Riley stripped it away and knocks it out of bounds. The Braves will hang on to it.
You know, an interesting note, even though Tulsa is in a zone here, Bradley still runs their man-to-man offense, which is called turnout. And you watch, you see a lot of movement.
Manuel with a three-pointer off the inbound play, and it's 19-4.
Or you can run that play.
Manuel all over Boudreaux, doing an excellent job on him. Now Jeff Riley with the hook. They call it the slingshot in Tulsa, and now a foul against one of the M&Ms, Tracy Moore. J.D. Barnett on the sidelines has a great record as an NCAA division coach. Has taken 6 of his last 7 teams to the NCAA tournament. Now Manuel throws it away, intended for Hawkins.
I think Anthony was confused that time. Tulsa switched back to a man-to-man. And I think he was a little confused. He saw someone guarding Hawk through the ballway.
Just over 12 minutes to play in the half. 19-4 Bradley. Now Riley lets it fly through his hands. And the Braves with a chance to go up by 17 or 18 if they get a three-pointer. That was Jeff Riley who let the ball blow right through. He's mishandled it twice now. Pass to Trippi. Couldn't get the shot off, and then Greg Jones tried to help him and hurt him instead by tipping it out of bounds.
You mentioned the fact that Tulsa switched defenses. That's kind of an effort to slow them down, isn't it? Confuse them a little bit offensively.
I think they're trying to confuse Anthony. I think they're trying to figure out a way to stop Hawk, to be honest with you. And they haven't done that yet.
Yeah. I wish them luck.
Hawkins on the steal. The manual. Braves coming down 4-on-2. Alley-oop to Luke. Couldn't make the play. Jones blows the rebound. Luke goes up and is fouled on the third attempt. He'll go to the free throw line. The foul is on Brian Riley, his first. Look at them dominate the boards here.
Tulsa's a good rebounding team, too. We saw a little bit of the USC game. Everything fell into their hands out there.
Number 43, Brian Riley, the club's leading rebounder at 8.2 a game, and Luke out-battled him.
He's leading the Valley in rebounding, too, so he's doing an excellent job for them on the boards.
This is Brian Lloyd, a freshman from Indianapolis's Lawrence North High School. He's 6'3", and he'll check into the ball game for Brian Riley, who is not at 100% with that flu problem. Jackson misses the second free throw, so it's a 20-4 score, and then Jeff Riley runs over Manuel again. Tracy Moore with a high arcing shot that's no good, and the Braves have a 3-on-1 break. Tipped away from behind by Moore, and Jeff Riley picks up the loose ball. Boudreaux will slow it down and catch his breath at the same time. The Braves have done exactly what they wanted to against Tulsa so far. And the Golden Hurricane looks a little tired. Jeff Riley open for the shot. That's his first points of the night. Tulsa has only 6 total.
Bradley's liable to let him shoot that from out there.
Hawkins in a crowd. Nowhere to go. Throws up a turnover, and it's picked off by Boudreaux. Into Brian Lloyd, the freshman. Makes a smart move. Back to Boudreaux for the three. And it's 20-9. Brian Boudreaux hitting 40% of his three-pointers this year entering this ballgame.
And that's better than he's shooting overall. Overall, he's shooting 36%, but he's a better shooter than that. Tulsa just doesn't need his output.
Moss on the bullet feed inside is fouled by David Moss.
He got a handful of his shirt when he turned around in the lane, too, and then he got him just for good measure as he went up with a shot.
I think what we're seeing, Tulsa is so conscious of guarding Hersey outside that it's opening some inside shots for Greg Jones and Luke Jackson. And that's important that, you know, Anthony and Trevor got to pick that up. When they're guarding Hawks so close, they got to punch it inside. It's opening the lane a lot. Those guys can get some easy five-footers.
Greg Jones at the line, shooting 50%. And he shoots 0% there. The Braves as a team shooting 70%. And their lead remains at 20-9 with 10:04 to play in the half.
2-2-1 press by Bradley.
Tulsa works it by that pressure. Donald Royster feeds Moore, who drives the bucket, goes up. No call, finally. Ron Zetcher races in there. And Rick Eichhorst indicates that it's on Greg Jones. That's his second. No call on Trimpy. There's Jones from the back.
Looks like Luke got a good portion of the ball going up.
Jerry Thomas into the ball game, averaging 5.7 points and 4 rebounds. The junior from Chicago Collins High School. He'll replace Greg Jones, who's in minor foul trouble. As Tracy Moore makes the first free throw, he has 3 points. He's really struggled lately. Despite being Tulsa's leading scorer, he's had only 12 points in his last two games combined.
And J.D. Barnett just doesn't know what to think of that. He really has struggled the last couple of games.
So he pulls the Hurricane within 9, with 9:53 to play in the half. And we'll be right back.
Selling cars at Heritage Buick Mazda has always been fun, but you ought to see us now. Colonial-style architecture creates a warm, relaxed atmosphere, and we have separated Buick and Mazda showrooms. Our new facility has been carefully designed to provide the finest automotive service in central Illinois. And our body shop has a dust-free paint area. I wonder where this goes. Ooh, not again! So come on into Heritage Buick Mazda and wish us well.
Now at Cohen's, the latest Amana radar range. This full-size radar range with 10 Cookmatic power levels, touchmatic controls, and digital readout makes cooking a breeze. Amana's exclusive RotoWave cooking system guarantees even microwave distribution. And Amana's 5-year warranty guarantees you years of convenient service. Regularly $299, now just $199 at Cohen's. You save $100 on an Amana radar range. An unbeatable value from Cohen's.
One unforgettable Saturday at the Silver Bullet.
Excuse me, Bob, please.
He's over there.
Coors Light, Lou.
Congratulations, Bob. You finally got a job. We'd like for you and your spouse to please move out of the house. Good luck, love, Mom and Dad. Yeah.
Hey, she's not bad.
And he's not Bob.
There's no slowing down with the Silver Bullet tonight.
The Pizza Bowl, tonight on Nightside.
A little later in the game, the North Point Video and Plaza Video Bradley Player of the Game will be named. North Point and Plaza Video will make a donation in the name of that player to Bradley University's General Scholarship Fund. We're seeing a great defensive job by a lot of guys out there on Bradley's side.
And so far, Trevor Trimpy, who's the great defensive player, also a pretty good offensive player. He's got 7 points, Hersey Hawkins with 9. They're the leading scorers for Bradley, which leads 20-11. Just under 10 minutes to play in this first half. And the Braves have the ball.
Bradley hasn't scored for a couple of minutes. In fact, Tulsa scored 7 straight on him now.
The Hawk is 5 out of 5 from the field.
Maybe I should have spoke up sooner.
The reason they haven't scored, they haven't got the ball to Hawk.
This is Royster, center against center, and Royster throws it off the irons. David Moss, only 2 points so far. Still with only 2. Make it 4, and it's 22-13 as the ball gets batted out of bounds. Ron Zetcher blows the whistle. You see teams all year long trying to throw that ball away before the Braves can inbound. It gives that defense time to get back. Southern Illinois was slapped with a technical for that a few weeks ago. But it has to happen a few times before the officials start calling it. This is Manuel, nowhere to go. Passes to Jackson with a soft touch. And it's a 24-13 Bradley lead with 8:50 to play in the first half.
Luke's maturing so quickly as a freshman, but I think in the next year or so, you'll see him take that one dribble and slam that one and really intimidate a team.
Boudreaux, one bounce to Royster. Luke all over him. Moss with the three-pointer, rims the basket, and the Braves kick it out in a hurry. This is Manuel. Back to Trippi. Open for the shot. It's a long one, so he passes it up. Hawkins, who's perfect, also let someone else handle it. Now Trippi, outside Manuel, picked up by Boudreaux. The Hawk, falling away from the bucket, is 6 out of 6, and he has 13 points, and the Braves lead by 13.
Don't think he's not working inside. Boy, they are grabbing him and holding him and knocking him around as he's weaving through those that double low post.
Eighth on Bradley's all-time scoring list. Would need 48 to move into seventh place. Tulsa throws the ball away. And the Braves will work it up the floor again.
You know, Bradley looks like the team that is a defensive specialist tonight. Now watch Hawk going off all these screens. That's how he's getting open.
Manuel would have been a three-pointer, but Hawkins is there to collect the trash, and he's 7 out of 7 from the field, 15 points, and we still have 7:30 to play in the half. Manuel didn't draw the foul. Now a mad scramble for the ball. The Braves take over. Here comes the Hawk. He's 8 for 8. The Braves by 17. An incredible performance by Hersey Hawkins. His career high is 37, and the ball is blocked away out of bounds by Luke Jackson.
You know, the way things are going, if I were Hawk, I think I might buy a lottery ticket today. I might ask him for numbers and buy one myself.
Boudreaux with a three-pointer. Hawkins with a rebound. Stripped away by Moore to Moss. Six points for Moss, and the Braves lead cut to 15. Brian Riley getting set to check back in. Jerry Thomas with his first shot, and it's perfect. The Braves have shot tremendously well in the first half against Tulsa. They shot 82% in the first half last Thursday against Creighton, so they continue that trend. The hook shot by Royster is nowhere near the mark, and Jerry Thomas rebounds. Crimpy. It's a three-pointer, and the game is a 20-pointer. Tulsa calls timeout, and it looks to kill. J.D. Barnett would be in court right now. We'll be right back.
Now, for a limited time only, get an incredible 80% discount on all in-stock cars and trucks at University Ford, Peoria's only 5-star Ford dealer. That's right, for 3 days only, get an 80% discount when you buy your new car or truck at University Ford. Stop in our showroom or meet us at the car show, January 29th through the 31st at Northridge Mall. Get the facts and save an incredible 80% on your next car or truck while they last. University Ford, Peoria's only 5-star Ford dealer. 3403 North University, Peoria.
Oh, hi, Sandy, it's me. No, I'm at home. The surgery? It was fine. Registering was a breeze, and the nurses were so nice. Why, before I knew it, I was on my way home. And guess what? It didn't cost nearly as much as an overnight stay in the hospital. Would I do it again? Definitely. Outpatient surgery at Methodist is just the greatest. Because now I'm home.
Outpatient surgery at Methodist. Because there's no place like home to recover.
This is Bill Elliott in the Coors Racing Team. Now, you might think we're sitting around here talking about hard work, determination, the winning edge, and all the skill it takes to make a great racing team and a great beer. Nah, We're talking about fast cars, pretty women, and easy drinking Coors.
But not necessarily in that order.
Too close for comfort. Weekdays at 4:30 on WEEK.
Well, the officials are going to let him play a little bit tonight. You guys were talking about giving Hawk some money to buy a lottery ticket. Forget the lottery ticket. I'm sending him to Wall Street with all my savings. Put it on whatever you want.
You know, Tracy Moore started out guarding Hawk. J.D. Barnett took him off him. Now they put Byron Bugeaud on him. I don't think it's going to matter. No matter who guards Hawk, he's scoring tonight.
They might as well put the student section on him because I don't think they could stop him either.
The Braves on a 15-4 run, leading 35-15. Hawkins is 8-for-8 from the field, and the Braves are shooting just under 70% as a team. Now Moss blows it away, or at least lets it go through his hands, and the Braves, once again, the benefactor of a turnover by the Golden Hurricanes. On the other hand, Tulsa is shooting only 30%. They're 6 out of 20. Has to get rid of it. He does it before the 5-second count expires. And they finally turn it over. Stan says, let me check the second hand on that watch.
Well, he was griping about a 10-second call earlier. The shot clock was down to about 32 earlier in the game, and Tulsa still hadn't gotten across the floor. So he wants the guys to watch the clock on both ends.
Moore, ice cold. And Luke Jackson battles the big man and comes away the winner. Braves by 20. Back to Hawkins. Slips as he tried to work it around the defense. Now Manuel on the fake. And then he's hit and lost the ball. At least they're consistent. They're not calling anything. There's Boudreaux. So Royster doesn't want the shot. Ryan Riley picked up by Thomas. Now Moore mishandles the ball, and Hawkins is there to pick it up. To Luke Jackson. Luke Jackson runs the floor so well. There are few centers in this league that get up the floor the way he does, and he's very dangerous in the trailer. 37-15, Bradley. Hits the back of the rim, and then he fouls Hawkins.
J.D. Barnett's got to be wondering whether he brought his team back from California or not. He might have left a few guys there. I'm not sure.
They must be very tired, too, because they played on Thursday, took off for California, came here, and then practiced last night.
And they really haven't practiced since Thursday's game. They traveled to California. They didn't practice out there. They just really shot and ran through a few things last night and did nothing today.
Jeff Riley back into the ball game for Tulsa, and he comes away with a loose ball. 4.5 minutes to go in the first half, and Bradley up by 22. And here's Boudreaux with Manuel. Moore open for the shot. Doesn't take it. And then a whistle away from the ball, and this will be against Trevor Crippen. That's his first, and only Bradley's third team foul, so they're not in danger of putting Tulsa in the bonus just yet.
I think the fans should watch Trevor guarding David Moss. Trevor's a very physical defensive player, and I think he's really frustrating David Moss. I think they should watch it. Moss is getting frustrated.
In it goes to Boudreaux, up top of the circle. Right wing Moss, inside Jeff Riley, back to Moss. Crimpy all over him. Boudreaux wearing Manuel like a jersey. Loose ball inside, and Royster makes something out of it. That's his first basket of the game. The Braves spread that offense out. Inside to Thomas, gets bumped. Has a shot blocked. And Tulsa trying to cut into a 20-point Bradley lead. Moore does. That's 6 points for him. He's averaging 16 a game. Manuel at the foul line, shoots over Moore and hits. Manuel with five. That's 1.5 below his average. Bradley Ball, says Ed Schumer. Brian Lloyd will check back in for Tulsa. And Tracy Moore will get a breather.
Just to give you an indication of how Tracy Moore has struggled the last couple of games, J.D. Barnett says that freshman Brian Lloyd played better than Moore did against USC. And as we said, Lloyd is just a freshman, so he's been having his troubles. But if he gets an open lane to the basket like he did a couple of times to go down the floor, he's going to be all right.
Thomas!
Good penetration and dish off by Anthony Manuel. Good catch also by Jerry Thomas.
A 41-19 lead for Bradley. Boudreaux outside, passes up the three-pointer, fires to Royster on the turnaround, and he hits it over Jackson.
Good matchup inside between Jackson and Royster. Royster tried to do something on the blocks before.
Manuel, as he cut down the middle, was fouled on the play. Anthony's taking his lumps tonight. It's the freshman Brian Lloyd who's charged with the foul. And J.D. Barnett up off the bench to dispute it. Well, he got a few elbows in there.
32.
Pretty good forearm smash, I'd say.
The next foul on Tulsa will put the Braves in the bonus. To play in the half of the Braves by 20 points. And Hawkins misses for the first time, but he gets the rebound. Inside to Thomas, who lays it in, and the Braves lead by 22 again. They have done almost nothing wrong tonight.
It's just a great athletic play by Hawk down at the other end. When he went up, he was going to shoot, then he was going to pass to Trevor. He still had time before he hit the floor to pass off to JT.
Here's Lloyd on the rebound, and the freshman is fouled by Anthony Manuel. With a minute 42 to play in the half, Trevor Trimpe is bleeding badly. Trevor Trimpe is at the Bradley bench, and he has been cut badly. He is holding his left hand, and he might need stitches.
I did not see how that happened.
It looked like he split his finger open. Could have been jammed.
Right between the little finger on his left hand and the ring finger. And it looked like that skin was broken, and he got quite a gash there. So he'll be taken care of in the locker room, and the Braves will bring in Paul Wilson. Averaging 11.5 points a game. Let's see if we can see how Trevor was hurt. He's okay there, or is he? He must have hit the rim or the net.
I don't know. Did he get up high enough to hit the rim?
I don't know. We'll give him that credit anyway. He'll like that.
Not his shooting hand.
He certainly didn't notice when it happened. It was a few seconds afterwards. A minute 28 to play in the half. Tulsa with the ball, but they trail the Braves by 22 points. This is Moss, and he's perfect. A three-pointer for Moss. He's got 9 points.
Losing Trevor could be very crucial. He probably won't miss his offensive output as much as the defensive job he was doing on Moss, as you mentioned earlier, Jeff.
And you notice Moss scored the first time when the first play he was out.
Whistle away from the ball on Jerry Thomas of Bradley, his first. With just over a minute to play in the half.
The last few minutes, you notice Tulsa's playing a little better, but they're playing even with Bradley. And when you're down 20 like they are, you can't afford to play even with somebody. They got to start causing some turnovers and creating some offensive opportunities.
Byron Boudreaux would be the man to start something like that. He's their leader in steals. The basket will count. says Rich Eichhorst. And the foul is on Paul Wilson. There he is bumping Moss.
Apparently the refs are pulling in the reins a little bit on the physicalness because that's been going on for 19 minutes and hasn't been called.
Moss has a dozen. His career high is 31. He got that against the Braves last year. Anthony Manuel short on the layup. Gets his own rebound. Puts it up as he falls. And with 30 seconds to play in the half, Tulsa will no doubt try to get the last shot here, trailing 43-27. A 14-point deficit is not exactly what they wanted going to the locker room, but it would be better than the 22 it was a few minutes ago. If they score, there are 12 seconds left in the half now. Wilson on Moss, his opposite number. Moss goes up, misses. Rebound stripped away from Royster by Jackson, and a foul on Donald Royster. The transfer from Mississippi with his first, and with 3 seconds left to go in the half, they'll walk the other way. And Luke Jackson will be at the line where he's really struggled this year.
You know, those are the kind of fouls that'll give coaches gray hair. 3 seconds ago, you know, rebound, Bradley's got to go 94 feet to score, and they give him a chance to shoot some free throws.
Jackson shooting only 47% from the line, blows the free throw, and Moss with a desperation heave at the buzzer is nowhere near the mark, and the Braves will go to the locker room, joining Trevor Trimpe, leading Tulsa 43-27. Back in a minute.
Baby, this sale's for us. Cribs, chests, dressing tables, high chairs, strollers, car seats, and nursery accessories. Now on sale at the Baby Corner, North University, Peoria.
We're celebrating our first year in our new facility at Peoria Toyota Volvo. And what a year it was. We shared the joy of our grand opening, went for the gold at the old prospector, romped through the sand at our beach party, enjoyed free air during our cool sale, and dazzled to our 87 roadshow. And now we're celebrating with $500 cash back on Toyota two-wheel drive trucks, $1,000 cash back on Toyota four-wheel drive trucks and FX16, and up to $2,000 cash back on MR2. It's party time at Peoria Toyota Volvo.
The Havana Merchants would like to congratulate Trevor Trimpe and the Bradley Braves. Here's to a successful 86-87 basketball season. Come visit our community, a nice place to live.
Early one afternoon.
Where's Lou?
At the Silver Bullet.
Lou, Jackie, comedian. You ever think of having live entertainment because this place is dead? Of course you did. I'm hysterical. Look at these reviews. Some of these places are still open. I'll pack them in, Lou.
No. Coors Light does that.
I don't know who this guy Light is.
No, Coors Light isn't a guy. It's a beer.
A bear. Terrific animal, actually. I can't get a break in this town.
Did you hear the one about the mouse?
Oh, there's no slowing down with the Silver Bullet tonight.
Enter the world of law and disorder on the next Entertainment Tonight. First, you'll witness how Susan Day has gone from a singing partridge to a swinging prosecutor in the hit series L.A. Law.
The law has to come first.
Plus, Judd Nelson is out for justice, and there's disorder in the court.
Hey!
Don't miss our exclusive preview of his new movie, From the Hip. All when you enter the world of Entertainment Tonight.
Tuesday at 6:30 on WEEK.
This Bradley basketball exclusive is brought to you by Coors, the beer with a difference worth tasting. Coors is the one. By Coors Light, there's no slowing down with the Silver Bullet. By Methodist Medical Center of Illinois, we're here to help. By McDonald's, it's a good time for the great taste of McDonald's. By University Ford, the only five-star dealer in Central Illinois. By Counter, put your money where your crop is. Use Counter. By North Point Video in Peoria and Plaza Video in Morton. By the Illinois State Lottery. Play Lotto. You could capture millions.
by Cohen's, downstate's largest home furnishers, and by Stauffer Chemical Company.
Cohen's is proud of Bradley University and all the Bradley Braves. Tonight, Cohen's congratulates number 32, Greg Jones.
Economists study it, bankers long for it, and citizens from all walks of life hope to improve it. What is it? Cash flow.
...of new cars at the best price. See your Pekin new car dealer today.
You can't beat the Pekin new car dealers.
Rest assured, wake up to Winter Watch on News 25 today.
With Lee Hall and former Bradley star Jim Les, this is Mark Strauss back at Carver Arena. We're at halftime, and Bradley leads Tulsa 43-27. We figured it'd be a closer game than it has been so far, but the Braves broke out to a 20-point lead, then a 22-point lead, and they've been able to hold on to most of it. Meanwhile, Trevor Trimpe left late in the first half with a large gash in his left hand, and Lee, you were in the locker room, and... Give us a report on that.
Well, I ran back there, and Trevor was coming out of the locker room, obviously in a great deal of pain. It was pretty shaky just to see it. He had his hand wrapped in a towel with ice. Apparently, he was kicked in the hand between his pinky and ring finger, and they are taking him to the hospital right now. Apparently, nothing broken, but again, he's in a great deal of pain and won't return tonight.
As for the rest of the Braves, they've taken the big lead over Tulsa. And Jim, Tulsa wanted to slow this game down. Now they have no choice but to speed it up and try to get some momentum and get some points in a hurry.
Yeah, they're definitely in trouble. Now they got to play the up-tempo game. They got to put pressure defense on, and they got to try and run and score points in a hurry. And that's into playing into Bradley's hands, so I think they should be in good shape. Another thing, with Trevor being out, Paul Wilson is going to have to guard David Moss. And we saw... towards the end of the half, just in a couple minutes, David Moss got a lot of easy shots when Paul was guarding him. Paul's got to be a little more physical and concentrate a little more defensively on stopping him.
Well, that's one thing the coaches were talking about the other day at practice. Trevor's been playing in place of Paul because he does such a better defensive job, and Paul really hasn't played as well defensively as they'd like him to. It's going to be interesting to see what happens here in the second half.
I think we also see another key on the stats. Bradley is out-rebounding Tulsa by 7. And that is a key towards getting their break going and establishing the game that they have established.
The Braves shooting 63% from the field so far and leading at halftime by a score of 43-27. And now let's take a break and hear from our friends at Bradley University. With Lee Hall and Jim Les, I'm Mark Strauss. We're at halftime at Carver Arena. Bradley 43 and Tulsa 27. And the Braves last Thursday did in the first half what they're doing to Tulsa tonight. They did it to Creighton, though, and former Bradley assistant coach Tony Barone. And Tony couldn't get out of town fast enough. But while he was here, we talked to him, and he told us that trying to rebuild a basketball program isn't easy.
We have had a very tough schedule. Schedule's been rated second in the country by USA Today. That's a cop-out, probably. We have four freshmen in the first eight. And I think what we've done is we've tried to develop our basketball team with keeping in mind that we do have freshmen on the team. And it's been a long evaluation process as to which kids react better to the pressure and which kids are going to have to take another 6 to 8 weeks to play basketball.
You talked just a second ago about the memories of this place. What kind of memories do you have?
Oh, this is a great place. You know, I've said since day one that Bradley University and the town of Peoria and the fans and the student body are second to none. The support is as enthusiastic as you'll ever find, and it's extremely loyal. And it's an ideal place to be at because of those particular characteristics. And my Kathy and the kids and I have nothing but the fondest memories about the people here and this old airplane hangar and the new arena. It was a great experience, but you know, you have to move on when you have a good opportunity. And I'm enjoying Creighton, and I think it's a good opportunity for us. And it's a big challenge, and I think we're doing okay there.
So Tony Barone visiting with R. Lee Hall while they were in Peoria last week. And right now, we're going to send it to our newsroom for a News 25 update with Tom McIntyre. Mac?
All right, thank you very much, gentlemen. Well, coming up after the game on News 25 Nightside, Peoria police still puzzling over the mysterious death of a man found on the Cedar Street Bridge this morning. His body found about 5 a.m. Authorities are saying yet if they have not ruled out foul play. The name of the victim still not released. Elsewhere, will a task force be looking into the problems of the Peoria Housing Authority? Well, if the PHA's director has his way, the answer to that question is yes. We'll have more on that. And Uncle Sam is telling all Americans to stay out of Lebanon because the government cannot guarantee their safety. Those stories and more coming up tonight on Nightside.
Now at Cohen's, this 25...
Love Connection, weekday mornings at 11:30 on WEEK.
Coming up later tonight, we will name a North Point Video Plaza Video Bradley Player of the Game. North Point and Plaza Video will make a donation in the name of our star of the game to Bradley University's General Scholarship Fund. That would have to be Hawk right now, unless things change drastically.
Boy, how could you pick anyone else? He is 8 out of 9 from the field, and he has 17 points here at the half, and we're going to take a look at the team stats first. The Braves shooting 63% from the field, and Tulsa, their opposite number, 36% from the field. Bradley out rebounding Tulsa, which we thought they'd have to do to dominate the game. And the Braves have only 9 turnovers so far, so that's not too bad. Hawkins with 17, Trevor Trimpe with 8, and he'll probably finish with 8 because he's at the hospital having that left hand looked at that he split late in the half. Thomas with 6, Manuel and Jackson with 5, and for Tulsa, not a lot to talk about. Moss has 12. And the rest of the team, 15.
Good to see nobody on Bradley in foul trouble. Jones and Luke. Luke doesn't have any. Jones only has 2. So inside, they are okay for this half. Let's hope.
The most points that an opponent has scored against Tulsa this year is 74. And the Braves have 43 already.
Jim, something you alluded to earlier tonight was the rebounding and the fact that that would allow Bradley to get out on the break. Nobody on Tulsa has over 3 rebounds, while Luke has 6 and Hawk has 7. So they're pretty controlling the boards pretty well.
Everyone's going to the glass. And another thing is great team play by Bradley. You notice, as a team, they have 16 assists amongst them, and Anthony Manuel has 8. And that's just a sign of good unselfishness. They're getting the ball to the open man. Even Hawk has 5 assists, even though he has 17 points. Good unselfish play. They're working for good shots. And when you have that many assists, that's a sign of good ball movement.
We're ready to start the second half, and the Braves will start it with the ball and a big 43-27 lead. Anthony Manuel in the front court passes to the corner for Hawkins, who misses. Did that only once in the first half. And Tulsa with a chance to put the first second half points on the board. Tracy Moore does, and he's fouled on the play. Looks like the Hawk will be charged with it. It's an offensive foul against Tracy Moore. That's his first.
This shows what happens if Moore gets loose and nobody helps out and picks him up.
Thomas on the dribble, guarded by Moss, back to Manuel. Moore picks him up. Off to Jones, but it's stolen by Donald Royster, and Sleepy D jams it.
Looks like he was trying to bring down the house. Something like that can get Tulsa ignited. Bradley's got to be very careful now to get a good shot.
Hawkins. No good, and Brian Riley, who had no points in the first half and limited play, brings down the rebound. Moss has 12, has 14. And they cut it to a 10-point game.
I think Stan Albeck wants a timeout right here.
Manuel calls it with only a minute 15 gone in the half, and Tulsa has scored all the points in the second half. They pulled within 10.
With George sick, I've had a lot on my mind. Thank goodness WeCare 65 helped me sort out all the Medicare red tape. The WeCare 65 representative explained the Medicare rules He helped me file insurance claims. Methodist even had a hotline to answer our questions and special classes on diet, exercise, and medication just for older adults like us. You know, I think Methodist really had us in mind when they set up We Care 65.
I always come to McDonald's. I love their salad.
You want to know what's in that salad?
I have
turkey, ham, radish, cucumbers, celery, and of course the lettuce and eggs and tomato.
Just like I would make at home if I had the time.
Stop by in the morning and put it in the refrigerator at work, and when I get back in the office, it's there waiting for me.
I need a salad. They all said McDonald's.
It's a good time for the great taste of McDonald's.
Hi, I'm Dean Grimm. Back in 1920, when Grimm TV and Appliance opened their doors, my grandfather, father, and uncles began to build a reputation for Grimm's, offering their customers fair prices, backed by good service and customer satisfaction. That family philosophy has become a tradition at Grimm's. As we begin another year, celebrate and save during our anniversary sale. Grimm TV and Appliance will serve you better because we care. Morton, Peoria, and Bloomington.
High Society on the next Oprah Winfrey Show.
Tulsa scored the first 6 points of the half. The Braves have the ball. They haven't done much with it since the first half, and now Moss steals the inbound, blows the jam. Here's Boudreaux picking up the long rebound. Jackson fights with him for it, and they tie it up. And that means Tulsa will have the ball on the alternating possession.
You know, a quick analysis right here in the opening minute and 15 seconds is Bradley just didn't come out as intense as they did at the start of the ballgame. Defensively, they're not picking up as tight as they were, and I think offensively, they're being careless, turning the ball over and taking some bad shots, and they're letting Tulsa in the game. You can't afford to do that with a good team like Tulsa. You got to bury them.
Tulsa did the same thing against Illinois State. They ran off 10 quick ones at Tulsa, and ISU never got back into the game till the end.
Brian Riley way out of his range. This is Boudreaux inside the Moss, has 14 points. Should have been 16, but he drew iron on that jam. Brian Riley throws up a brick, and Luke Jackson comes away with a rebound. He had six in the first half. Manuel with a three-pointer. Well, that solves problems in a hurry when you're good out there. Royster throws up a prayer. Moss with the rebound. Drake Jones jumping around in his face, so Tulsa throws it out to Boudreaux, their point guard, to set things up. It's 46-33. The Braves up by 13 thanks to the three-pointer by Anthony Manuel. Moore is fouled. Manuel wanted a walking call against him. The foul's on Anthony. That's his second. Here's Moss. Would have been a three-pointer. Instead, it's Jerry Thomas's ball out to Manuel. Another three-pointer. Wow. That from a guy who was hitting only 32% outside that stripe. Brian Riley holds it over the head to Moore. Manuel picks him up. Hawkins tried to steal it. Manuel's called for the foul. And that's three on Anthony. He's played a steady game tonight. They don't want him to get into foul trouble. And it goes to Moore. And he ran into Luke Jackson, and it's an offensive foul. I think he thought that he was getting those calls all night and tried one more time. He didn't get it that time, though.
Tracy Moore is third.
His third, he checks out. Brian Lloyd back into the ball game. A 16-point Bradley lead with 17 minutes to play in the game. Tulsa got within 10 in the early minutes of the second half, and now we get an offensive foul against Luke Jackson. The first on him, and the third on the Braves in the half.
Seems to be the call of the half. We've had three offensive fouls in the first 3 minutes of the half.
Boy, the first half, you wouldn't have known these guys had whistles.
How hard is that for a player to adjust when they call it so loosey-goosey in the first half, and then second half they come out and call everything?
It's very difficult.
Moss almost walked, no call. Riley long jumper goes off the iron, no good. Luke Jackson with the rebound. He's crashed the boards tonight. Manuel had it stripped away from behind. Hawkins recovers. Now Greg Jones with a jumper. Yes! 51-33. The Braves lead back to 18. That means the Braves have reeled off 8 points in a row after a six-point run by Tulsa. We're right at the seesaw. Ryan Riley on the rebound dumps one in. His first points of the ball game. He's averaging 12 a game, but he's really hurting with that flu bug. Hawkins passes up the shot and got a little bit too generous, and Stan Albeck's yelling at him about it.
You know, Lee, you mentioned about the officiating. You know, as teams go in the locker room and their coaches talk to them, when the officials go in at halftime, they also talk about how the game's going in and whether it should be called a little tighter or not.
Fouls on Greg Jones.
And apparently they've decided it should be called a little tighter.
They've also decided it should be called on Jerry Thomas and not Greg Jones. It's Thomas' second.
Second foul on Thomas.
Well, Luke did a pretty good job of turning into the baseline. You can't do a whole lot more than that. Royster was just in a really bad spot underneath the basket, but he still made something out of it.
Shooting only 49% from the line, and that's why. They call him Sleepy D. He's a transfer from Mississippi and a former high school teammate of Tulsa's David Moss. Royster cannot salvage the second free throw. He goes to the line and comes up empty. 51-35, Bradley lead is 16. 15:50 to play in the game. Manuel picked up by the freshman Lloyd. Now he's double teamed to Thomas, who goes to the hoop, scores, and the foul is on Tulsa. Boudreaux. That's his second. And now let's see if JT can convert on the three-point play. We'll see it one more time.
Great acrobatic move by JT. He gets hit in the air and still has a presence of mind to concentrate and get the ball in the hoop.
And that's one danger of double teaming somebody. They double teamed Ants out here in the key, and JT was wide open, taking it to the basket.
Thomas has bettered his average. Doesn't pat it more, however, at the free throw line, where he too has had problems, only 33%. Brian Lloyd across the line, one bounce to Royster, out top Moss. To Boudreaux. Now Moss, the three-pointer. It's short. Percy with the rebound. The Braves come running up the other way. Thomas. And he landed on Boudreaux hard. Boudreaux fell on his shoulder, and Thomas fell on him. And Boudreaux crawls in front of Frank Blaine, our cameraman. This one's getting way out of hand now. There it is.
You got to give Boudreaux some credit. You know, having some guts and standing in there and taking that charge. Even though he didn't get the call, you know, that's a gutsy play. And 9 times out of 10, you're going to get that call.
It takes a lot to get Byron Boudreaux out of a ball game. He has missed only one game in his entire Tulsa career, and 5 times this year he's played all 40 minutes. Here's the Hawk, top of the circle.
Tulsa's in the zone on the out-of-bounds play. Alley-oop.
Technical against Hersey for hanging on the rim. They're going to call a technical foul against Hersey Hawkins for hanging on the rim. Both officials are unhappy. Stan Albeck's unhappy because of the technical, and J.D. Barnett's unhappy because Tulsa had the ball and was racing the other way. And now Stan Albeck wants to use the replay in order to decide the play.
The reason Coach Albeck is upset is the fact that he felt Hawk, as he was going up, was being undercut.
He was clearly undercut. Yeah, there's no way you can call a technical on that. No way.
The rule is, if you feel you're a player, you feel you're being undercut, you can hang on to the rim to protect yourself. That's what Coach Albeck was arguing. Obviously, J.D. Barnett agreed with officials.
There you see Coach Albeck right in front of us, screaming at the refs. He wants to see it on the replay. He saw the replay. He's pointing at the screen right now.
He wants Ron Zetsche to look at our replay. But Zetsche won't do it. And Tulsa will have the ball with 15 minutes to play in the game. Bradley 53, Tulsa 36. Here's Moore. Jeff Riley has it stripped away by Hawkins, and they call a foul on the Hawks.
And it is getting physical out there.
It's a war underneath the board.
I'm glad I'm sitting where I am.
Well, just when it looked like the officials were trying to get a hold on the game after that physical first half, they let the thing with Boudreau and JT go down here, and then they call Hawks. It's going to get out of hand here quickly.
They called nothing in the first half, and they are wearing out the warranty here in the second half. Here's Lloyd, stripped away by Hawkins. Jackson blows the rebound, and Ron Zetcher blows his whistle. Well, let's see what this one's all about. This one's on Lloyd. Make it Tracy Moore, and it's his fourth, so they'll have to take him out of the ballgame. They take Lloyd out instead. We'll have to double check. It is on Tracy Moore, his fourth. Boudreau back in for Tulsa. He's all right. Manuel, a three-pointer. And the lead is 20 again. And he has hit four of four three-point attempts. Tulsa with a bomb that doesn't go. Here's Boudreau to Mott. Fakes around Thomas. Not open for the shot. Rod Parker getting second check in for Tulsa at the next chance. We have 14 minutes to play in the game. And Bradley up 56-36. Make it 56-38. As Moss hits the turnaround in the lane, he has 17. Moss has had some big games against Bradley. Last year, he scored 31 and 22 in the Missouri Valley Conference Championship game. Jones with a move inside, has it batted away, and here comes Tulsa running. Moore, pull-up jumper. No good. Thomas with a rebound. And the Braves come back the other way. Manuel outside to Hawkins. Drives on Boudreau. Nowhere to go. Passes to Jones, and we get a whistle on Boudreau. That'll bring Rod Parker into the game, the freshman from Bellwood, Illinois, Proviso West High School. That's the third foul on Boudreau, and here it is.
It's a good thing Hawk doesn't have his wallet with him out on the floor, because he's being mugged every time on the offensive end of the floor.
That's a good point, Lee. I think the fans should watch Hawk running off the picks. Guys from Tulsa are jumping out, holding, grabbing. He ought to wear some handlebars, I think.
He's not doing much running. He's running out of the crowd because he's getting elbowed into the first row every time down.
Not only is he being mugged, but he's been shut out here in the second half. Luke goes up in a crowd, and he's fouled by Moss. And now Tulsa's in foul trouble. Moore has four, and Moss with his third, with 13-10 to play in the game.
Well, Moss and Luke exchanging a few words. Moss getting a little ugly out there.
I think he was just asking where he's eating after the game, Lee. I'm not too sure about that.
Okay.
Jackson, one out of three at the free throw line. Make it two out of four.
See, players know all this stuff, you know. It's just, we don't pick up on things.
He used to ask me that all the time last year.
Yeah.
It's a 20-point lead again, 58-38, with 13-10 to play. And this is little Rod Parker from Proviso West High School. 6-foot freshman. Off to Boudreau. Now to Moss. He's picked up by Jackson. Moss with a three-point attempt.
David Moss, three.
They're knocking him down right and left. Both teams are. That's 20 points for David Moss. Jim Les is sitting here wishing they had that three-point rule when he was playing.
That would have been nice. It would have been a lot of fun.
What's the matter? Missouri Valley Conference Player of the Year wasn't enough, huh?
I would have liked to boost it up my average a little better. It sounds good when you're in a bar 20 years from now.
You'll boost it up anyway. Here's Manuel, guarded by the freshman Parker. Luke's wide open, he takes it, misses it. Rebound batted around, Jones.
Bradley is just out-hustling Tulsa on the board. Just out-scrapping them, out-hustling them.
J.D. Barnett said Illinois State's a better team than Bradley. I wonder if he changed his opinion now. And a walking call on the Golden Hurricane. 11:58 to play. And J.D. Barnett can't see it click off fast enough. It's a 19-point Bradley lead. Paul Wilson ties his shoe, or at least the Hawk does. He's ready.
I'm wondering if Sand didn't have that written in big letters in the Bradley locker room. That's all it takes to get them fired up. Tell them that ISU is better than Bradley. That would be a good motivator, I would imagine.
Tulsa's gone back to a zone, it looks like.
It really doesn't matter whether Bradley or ISU are better than one another, but if you tell one of those teams that the other is better, that's all it takes to get them
wound
up.
That's exactly what I was trying to get across.
There's a foul on Parker.
Stan Albeck was up on the sideline yelling, and I think what he was trying to get across to Bradley was the fact that, hey, we're in the lead, we're up 19, there's 11 minutes, 30 seconds to go, let's take good shots. You know, wait, be patient, and work for good shots. You see Anthony Manuel work, penetrate a little bit, got fouled, and that's what you want to do.
They put Manuel into the bonus with the foul by Parker, but he misses the front end of it. Tracy Moore back in the game along with Jeff Riley, David Moss, Donald Royster, and Rod Parker for Tulsa. The Braves with Manuel, who tries to strip it away from Parker. Jones, Luke Jackson, who does take the steal. Hawkins and Jerry Thomas. So Jackson with the steal and Manuel with the dribble. 11 minutes to play. Bradley by 19. They've won 23 in a row here at Carver Arena, and the foul's inside against Donald Royster. And when you consider that they're playing this well against a big team like Tulsa that really likes to bang you around, and Donald Powell is on the bench, it's really impressive.
Well, I think another good sign is the fact that Tulsa came out red hot at the start of the second half, scored like six or seven straight points in half and had the momentum going, but it's a sign of a good team when you can combat that. And you rebel them, trying to come back and get back in the game. Bradley built up their lead right back, and now they're in control of the game.
That's Hersey Hawkins' first point of the second half.
Tulsa's had a devil of a time in their three losses. The only times they were down at the half were the two times that they lost. Two of the times they lost, TCU and Colorado. When you get jump on them early like Bradley did, they just have a tough time coming back.
19 points for Hawkins. The lead's 21 for Bradley, and now Manuel strips it away from Rod Parker. Ahead to the Hawk. And he got kicked by Royster. Royster comes over to make sure he's all right. Hawk faked him out of his sneakers. That's three on Donald Royster.
You know, good play by Anthony down at the other end, getting the steal. The freshman guard, it's a good idea to put a lot of pressure on him. Great, and here comes a great fake by Hawk.
Well, Royster gets up there, doesn't he? His feet were at eye level.
Just very quickly, Mark, you mentioned Donald Powell a couple of minutes ago. He's going to the doctor tomorrow to get his cast changed. And a little bit of a checkup, they'll x-ray his wrist. Hopefully he'll get a soft cast put on that tomorrow. And he's just going crazy. He wants to hear from the NCAA one way or another. If he would hear yes or no, that'd be good enough for him. I'm sure he'd rather hear yes on the red shirt, but he just wants to know one way or the other.
He's getting antsy.
You bet.
That's 20 points for Hersey Hawkins. The Braves by 22, 63-41. Make it 63-43 as Tracy Moore cans the bomb. 10.5 minutes to play, and Moore is finally in double figures with 10. We told you he'd been struggling. Manuel with a pass underneath to Jackson. That's 9 points for Luke. He's over his average. Moore inside. Crazy looking shot, but it goes in. Other end of the floor to Hawk. Who touched it last? Bradley. We've got 9:58 to play in the ball game, and the Braves leading by 20 points, 65 to 45. We'll take a break and be right back.
Now, for a limited time only, get an incredible 80% discount on all in-stock cars and trucks at University Ford, Peoria's only 5-star Ford dealer. That's right, for 3 days only, get an 80% discount when you buy your new car or truck at University Ford. Stop in our showroom or meet us at the car show, January 29th through the 31st at Northwich Mall. Get the facts and save an incredible 80% on your next car or truck while they last. University Ford, Peoria's only 5-star Ford dealer. 3403 North University, Peoria.
When you switch to Eradicane to save money over Duel or Lasso, you won't take a chance on performance. Eradicane gives excellent control of foxtails and other grasses and puts it in writing with one of the strongest guarantees around. Apply Eradicane right, and if it doesn't work, you'll get a rescue treatment at no charge. Ask your dealer about the Eradicane guarantee. Then ask to see the Duel or Lasso guarantee. You can't lose when you switch and save with Eradicane.
He's right, you know.
Switch and save with Eradicane.
If you're tired of sweatpants that can turn into sweat knickers after one washing, and sweatshirts that can't hold up to a backyard first down, Brown Sporting Goods has the sweats you'll go for. New premium white sweats are the best ever, built by the folks who are experts at making comfortable yet rugged athletic wear. Russell Athletic sweats are heavier, thicker, and softer, built tougher to last longer, and shrink less than ever. In short, we at Browns think they're the best you can buy for the money. Russell Athletic premium sweats at all Brown Sporting Goods locations.
Today, weekdays at 7 on WEEK.
This dazzling display of Bradley dominance is protected by broadcast rights granted by Bradley University and the Missouri Valley Conference. Any rebroadcast or other use without the express written consent of WEEK and Bradley University is prohibited.
Bradley 65, Tulsa 45. You see the time remaining, just under 10 minutes. And the Braves have everything going for them, including the foul situation. Tulsa in a little foul trouble, the Braves are not. I believe Tracy Moore has 4 fouls. And David Moss has 3.
And
Anthony Manuel has 3. For the Braves, so he's the only one in any kind of trouble for Bradley. Brian Riley back into the ball game. You saw a glimpse of him earlier. Moore misses the bomb, and Bradley with a chance to build on their 20-point cushion.
You're seeing a little different offense here with Hawk at the point, running off the screen off Luke here.
Goes to the hole.
You know, that's a pretty good offense, I think.
That guy with the red 33 on his chest is a pretty good offense.
Yeah, that's right. Any play with him involved in it is going to work.
Give him the ball and watch.
Moore has it blocked from behind. I think it was Hawkins who did it. Hawkins has 22 points so far. I'd like to score 22 points and be under your average. The average is 25 and a half. Brian Riley with a three-pointer. He has 5 points. Hawkins works around the screen set by Jackson. Now in the front court, passes it off to Manuel, top of the key. Moss on him. Right. Here's JT with the hook. David Moss works it up the floor in a hurry. Outside that three-point line to Riley, who throws it up nowhere near the mark. Luke Jackson tried to save it, but gets nothing but a floor burn. Nice try, though.
Jim, you talked about watching Hawk go through the double pick down low. I don't think the refs are, because he got nailed. He got a forearm smash, and I watched it go by. Yeah.
Moore with 14 points, so he has started to break into the scorebook with a little regularity here. Hawkins has it stripped away by Moore, and Moss goes in unguarded. The lead's been cut to 15. Manuel works between two Tulsa players all the way up the floor to the baseline where he lost the ball, but it's picked up by Greg Jones.
Hands off.
Fans here hollering for a foul, and Manuel worked it out of pressure from the backcourt. Puts the moves on two Tulsa players to Hawkins. Jones on the tip in. Greg Jones done a good job on the boards this year, 5.5 per game.
You know, it's amazing. You look at Greg, his size, and he still jumps so well.
Moore on the shot, and the foul's on Greg Jones. That's his third. So he and Manuel both have three, and Jones checks out, or at least comes over to talk to Stan Albeck. And there you see the foul situation. Tracy Moore, who's fouled out of two games already this year, is one foul away from doing it again. Only four times this year has a Tulsa player fouled out of a game. And we're talking 17 games. The Braves have had four players foul out of one game.
You know, I think the thing, Coach Albeck called Greg over here to talk to him, and I think what he was saying was, hey, if Tulsa's going to get back into the game, don't let them do it at the free throw line. Make them try and use up the clock trying to run their offense. We don't want to foul them and let them score without the time runs.
Now Moss fouls Anthony Manuel. And that's four on David Moss. With 8 minutes, or at least with 7 minutes and 28 seconds to play.
How many times you see a 6'7 guy like David Moss guarding the point guard, bringing the ball up like that one-on-one?
Manuel shooting 81% from the free throw line. Hits the first.
As a point guard, you look at someone like that, 6'7", trying to guard you, and you kind of lick your chops and say, okay, you're going for a ride, pal.
Second one rims out. Jeff Riley on the rebound. And Tracy Moore works it up to the front court. This is Brian Lloyd, the freshman.
Brian Lloyd.
His first points of the game. Bradley's lead is 70-55. There he is setting up defensively. Manuel to Luke Jackson. 11 points for Luke. His career high is 16. Rebound back tapped. Moore to Lloyd. The freshman couldn't put it down this time, though. Now a loose ball, and the Braves come up with it thanks to the work of Anthony Manuel ahead to Thomas. Things a little wild out there now. The hook by Luke Jackson doesn't go, but he's fouled in the play. With 6:37 to play in the ball game. That's Rodney Johnson who checks in, the freshman redshirt out of Indianapolis. He replaces David Moss, who has four fouls. So it's Johnson and Lloyd, a couple of freshmen. Jeff Riley, Donald Royster, and Tracy Moore for Tulsa. Luke Jackson hits the first free throw. It's 73-55, Bradley. How about that? He hit them both.
That's something new. I kind of like that.
A 19-point lead, and the freshman is long on the shot, but Jeff Riley's there to clean up on the rebound. Lead down to 17 again. Rodney Johnson putting all kinds of pressure on Anthony Manuel, staying right with him, doing a good job. And now Manuel dribbles the ball out of bounds. He says he was pushed by Tracy Moore. Stan Albeck says, just get back, boys. Just get back on defense. Forget about it. 6:10 to play. The lead is 17. Moore trying to cut into it three at a time. Could not. Royster with a dunk. And it's 74-59.
Kelsey's really getting after the offensive boards the last couple of times down the floor.
Well, that one was obvious. Rodney Johnson with his first foul, and he'll come out of the ball game for David Moss. Boy, Anthony Manuel is really taking his lumps tonight. But he's not giving an inch.
And I think just about everybody on the team is going to wake up with a few bruises tomorrow and a few aches and pains from a lot of elbows.
Manuel with the 1-1. The lead's 15 and remains that way. Again, in the first half, Trevor Trimpe split his hand open, and he is at a hospital having that taken care of. It was his left hand. He split it between the ring and pinky of his left hand. Moore goes up, but without the ball. Manuel has that with 5:20 to play in the ball game. Bradley by 15. Little game of cat and mouse at the top of the circle. And it goes to Hawk, now to Jackson for the reverse layup. And he's fouled as he goes up by Jeff Riley.
Bradley showed good patience at times, working the clock, running their offense, getting a good shot.
Looks like it was Brian Lloyd who fouled him instead. And Luke's back at the line. He's hit his last four free throw attempts. At least he had until I opened my big mouth. The officials aren't even sure who the foul is on. And it is on Brian Lloyd. 4:57 to play. And Jackson increases it to a 16-point lead. Luke has 14. Here's Royster on the turnaround, banks it in. 75-61, Royster in double figures with 10. Here's Manuel, works it across the timeline as he's double teamed. Now around Moss, Tracy Moore picks him up. Boy, the floor is slippery. Here's Hawkins outside. Says, let's not get too wild here. Got plenty of time on the shot clock. 25 seconds remaining on that. Backs it in against Lloyd. Out to Luke. Foul line jumper. No good. Luke gets his own rebound. A new 45, and the Braves continue to control it. 4 minutes to play in the game. There's Manuel. Works around a screen set by Jackson. Bradley hollering for a foul. Won't get one. Apparently the whistle's gone back into the pocket. To Jerry Thomas. Plays it in. 10 points for JT. A 77-61 lead. Royster at the other end, and he's called for the charge. Down to 3:42 to play, and we have a timeout on the floor. Bradley up by 16, and we'll take a breather.
Now, for a limited time only, get an incredible 80% discount on all in-stock cars and trucks at University Ford, Peoria's only five-star Ford dealer. That's right, for 3 days only, get an 80% discount when you buy your new car or truck at University Ford. Stop in our showroom or meet us at the car show, January 29th through the 31st at Northwoods Mall. Get the facts and save an incredible 80% on your next car or truck while they last. University Ford, Peoria's only five-star Ford dealer. 3403 North University, Peoria.
Meet some more farmers who switched and saved with Eradicane. Here's Terry Jameson.
Eradicane saved me $2.48 an acre over Lasso.
Eradicane users are getting guaranteed control at a lower price than Dual or Lasso, right, Gary Williams?
Yeah, I saved $3.50 an acre over Dual and got excellent control on the foxtails.
Switch and save with Eradicane, like the Johnson brothers.
Did a better job than Dual on my grasses and at $2.50 an acre less.
He's right, you know.
Hey, Glenn, how you doing?
Switch and save with Eradicane.
When you talk to the experts from Coors about their beer, this is what happens. Now, this is great. Bob Foster here says that his special blend of hops is the one thing that gives Coors its character and its taste. The one thing. Darwin Davidson says it's his two-row barley. And Sun Lee claims it's his specially cultured yeast. That's great. Come on, guys. What is it?
Barley.
I love it. You want to know why Coors is the one?
Teamwork.
Put your sleep problems to rest forever next Donahue.
Luke stood in there and took the charge.
And the official who made the call underneath Rich Eichhorst, he's famous for his offensive fouls. You might remember down at Wichita State last year, he's the one that called five against Hawk.
Don't forget, after the game, News 25 Nightside, Tom McIntyre and Shelley Dankoff, Bill Houlihan's weather, and the latest sports highlights from our own Paul Wapple. News 25, the team Central Illinois depends on.
Well, there's J.D. Barnett, whose teams last year only allowed 58 points per game. But the Braves have scored 77, and that's the most scored against Tulsa this year. It'll be a load of fun to travel home with after this one, won't it? Whistle away from the ball up court, and it looks like it's on Jeff Riley. Now Jeff Riley and Greg Jones start to converse, and it's not about the weather.
No, it's about where they're eating after the game, right? See,
right,
I'm learning
right.
This. I'm picking this stuff up. If we didn't have a wooden floor down, he'd be sitting in the penalty box for 2 minutes.
Maybe that was Jeff's second round in WWF tonight.
Here's Jones at the line, and Greg sinks the first free throw.
Yeah, those guys are in town later on this week, too. We're going to talk to them.
If I could get that guy, I'd rip his head off.
I don't know. It's one of those wrestling guys. I can't remember his name.
Riley with the rebound.
Randy Savage, isn't it?
Yeah.
Macho Man Savage.
I think Riley's wrestling George Steele later this week. Inside it goes to Royster, and he banks it in. Tracy Moore will check in at the next chance. That's 12 for Royster.
You know, I'm impressed with Royster. He's been doing a good job of giving it Tulsa an inside game.
And it goes to Luke, and he's fouled. And this is on Lloyd. Freshman Brian Lloyd. And that foul gives Tracy Moore a chance to check back in. He'll replace freshman guard Rodney Johnson. 3:08 to play, and Bradley by 15. They led at halftime, 43-27, a 16-point bulge, so it hasn't changed much since.
You know, here we see Tulsa, as we talked about earlier, is forced to come out and play a lot of pressure defense, picking up at half court and at full court, and Bradley's taking advantage of it. They're much quicker than Tulsa is. They're getting easy shots, and if they don't get the shots down, they're getting fouled and going to the free throw line.
Luke misses the free throw, and it's been a real stigma for him. 6 out of 10 at the line for the night. Make it 7 out of 11. 79-63, and Luke has 15. That's one below his career high. He had 16 against SIU earlier this year. Tracy Moore with the jumper. And the lead's down to 14, and Moore has 17 points for Tulsa. And another foul up court. It's on Brian Lloyd, number 34. That's his sport.
Officials have to be very careful. You notice there's a lot of fouls now away from the ball. You know, I think it's a combination of Tulsa being frustrated and Bradley being a little excited that they're so ahead. We don't want to have anything dumb happen. Any players get into a fight, someone get hurt. The refs have to be very careful here.
misses the free throw. Greg Jones hustles after it, but he can't get there before the ball goes out of bounds. Now we have Moore, Moss, Lloyd, and Royster all with four fouls for Tulsa. And they would need a miraculous 2 minutes and 51 seconds here to get back in this one. They're down by 14 points. Moore inside, banks it up, no good. And another whistle. Greg Jones, and it's his fourth. Tried to avoid him, and it's hard to tell from that shot whether or not he did. John Zetcher didn't think he did.
He tried to get over and help, and he just got there a little bit too late.
That's 18 points for Moore. Make it 19. And at halftime, Tracy Moore only had six. 2:40 to play. Tulsa is within 12. That's the closest they've been for a while. Manuel works it around Moore into the front court with the pass to Hawkins. And once again, we get a whistle away from the ball, and now we've got danger of all heck breaking loose. Greg Jones' temper has just about had it. Jeff Riley's been all over in the last few minutes, and the fuse is gone.
He's got to walk away from that.
That's what Jeff Riley's for.
Down three.
It'll put Bradley at the free throw line. He wants two shots. He doesn't want a one and one. Stan wants two shots.
I think what he wants is, I think he might want two shots and someone to be ejected. You know, that might be one thing to calm this game down.
For Jerry Thomas. Make it 11. And a 13-point Bradley lead. The Braves have 80. 2.5 minutes to go. Isaac shoots it. Misses it. Jeff Riley on the rebound to Moore. Works it around Hawks. And the tip in by Riley. And Tulsa's within 11. Moore going for the steal. Anthony races past him in front of our broadcast position here. And into the top of the circle. Out of the foul line. Inside he goes all the way to the hoop, but he came up short. They try to cut it to a 9-point game. Moss in the front court. A three-pointer is good. And they're within 8 now, 80-72 with a minute 55 to play.
I think Bradley needs a timeout to settle down here.
And that's exactly what they do. A minute 51 to play in the game. It's the Braves 80 and Tulsa 72. Hang on, we'll be right back for the finish.
To get the most from your corn crop, you need maximum performance from your corn soil insecticide. That's why top growers depend on Counter with its unique Action 3. Counter controls rootworms, wireworms, and other major corn pests three ways. With proven contact, systemic, and residual control. For consistent control and superior performance, put your money where your crop is. Get Counter with Action 3.
Now at Cullen's, the complete line of Whirlpool dishwashers and compactors. Innovative design and convenience for today's kitchens. Whirlpool dishwashers with power clean, energy saver washing systems and quiet wash. The latest in technology and the ultimate in style. And Whirlpool compactors for convenience. All at Cullen's unbeatable prices. Whirlpool, making your world a little easier. An unbeatable value from Cullen's.
With Cliff Lee Hall and Jim Les. This is Mark Strauss at Carver Arena. The Braves leading Tulsa 80-72 with a minute 51 to play in the ball game. And there's J.D. Barnett. His team needs points in a hurry.
Mark, it's interesting. It's going to be interesting to watch the final 151. When I talked to J.D. yesterday, I asked him about the three-point shot. Very simply, he said, I hate it. It's ridiculous. Hasn't changed the inside game, and it helps make a game out of a blowout. Well, I think you would agree that this was at one time a blowout, and it's going to be interesting to see if they try and make use of that in the final 151.
Another point we should make here is that Byron Boudreaux, who tried to come back into the ball game after he was fallen on by Jerry Thomas, is in his warm-ups and not going to come back on the floor, and he's their best three-point shooter at 40%. They send in Rodney Johnson, the freshman. So we'll see who starts taking the three-point shots, probably Moss.
Well, we saw Moss hit one just before the timeout, and he's just at 39% as well, so he's the guy going to be popping.
Paul Wilson into the ball game, trying to inbound, and it's swatted out of bounds by Tulsa.
Tulsa at an even 33% on the night. They're 5 of 15 from the three-point range, so he might hate it, but they're still shooting it.
Well, it's a rule, so you might as well use it. He might not like it, but he'd like to win with it. Down to a minute 45. The Braves lose the ball, but Manuel's fouled by Rodney Johnson. Johnson came over to Tulsa with J.D. Barnett. He was originally recruited by Virginia Commonwealth when Barnett was the head coach over there. His brother Greg is also a member of the squad, but he hasn't been suiting up for games. That's the third on Johnson. Manuel trying to put points on the board for the free throw line, and he does. Boy, you don't want to miss him now. 16 points for Anthony Manuel. His career high was that 19 at ISU last week. And he makes it a 10-point Bradley lead. Let's see what Tulsa does here. They put it up immediately, and the three-pointer is no good. Ahead to Hawkins. And he's fouled on the play by Tracy Moore, and Moore has fouled out of the ballgame. Only the fifth time a Tulsa player has fouled out this year. And they lose a good outside shooter without him.
Well, we mentioned the fact that Moore had struggled, but the last couple of games, he came on strong in the second half. There you see Hawk. Moore obviously can run faster without the ball than Hawk can with.
Well, you know, if there's anything as a nice foul, I got to believe Tracy Moore gave Hawk a nice foul. You know, Hawk's going full speed. Tracy Moore's running alongside of him. You know, there's an opportunity there to take a guy out and injure a guy. And, you know, sometimes in the heat of the game, guys may do that. But he made sure Hawk didn't get the shot off, but kind of fouled him where he wasn't going to hurt him. I'll give him credit for that.
Now, he's not really a member of that, I don't know, what do you want to call him, the Thug Brigade?
I don't think those guys are quick enough to get down and catch up with Hawk.
Tulsa doing some wholesale substitutions here. Jeff Riley checks out. Donald Royster checks in. Ryan Lloyd went in for Moore, who fouled out with 19 points. David Moss is Tulsa's leading scorer with 25. And Hersey Hawkins is Bradley's leading scorer with 23 after that free throw. Trying to raise the lead to a dozen. He does it. 1:29 left. It's three-point time if you're Tulsa. Moss puts a bomb up. Banks it up, no good. Jones with a rebound. Ahead to Wilson. Blind pass to Hawk, couldn't hold on to it. We'd have seen a gorilla dunk if he'd have had that ball.
Hawk smiling, he know he should have had that one.
Moss, rebound Johnson. Timeout Tulsa. A minute two to play and the lead down to 10. Well, that's an awfully big lead when there's only a minute two left to go. We'll be back in a minute.
I think salad at McDonald's is a fast way to get a good nutritious meal.
I started with my burger and then went to the salad with that fresh lettuce, and it was great. It
has a heck of a lot more chicken than I've seen in any other salad. The teriyaki sauce is terrific, and it fills me up. It's a meal.
It's fresh. It's always crispy. It's always tasty.
I love the salad so much, it's just hard not to dig right in.
It's a good time for the great taste of McDonald's.
Past record sales at Bob Grimm Chevrolet have produced the finest selection of clean used cars and trucks in central Illinois. So Bob says, let's clean them out and let's keep them clean for a year. Any new or used car or pickup sold this month with a value of $900 or more will receive 52 free car wash tokens. That's right, you'll get 52 free car wash tokens. Go to local car wash outlets to keep your car or pickup clean for a year. Use them once a month and they'll last 4 years. You clean up on our prices and we'll keep it clean. Bob Grimm Chevrolet in the Field Shopping Center, Morton. Today's Business, weekday mornings at 6 on WEEK.
Bradley 84, Tulsa 74, a minute 2 to play. From here, the Braves head to Wichita State for a game on Thursday, and then we'll be back on the air with Bradley Basketball on WEEK Saturday night at 7:30 when the Braves go to Des Moines for a game with the Drake Bulldogs, the site of the first miracle shot last year.
Too bad we weren't there last year. I guess Illinois State had kind of a tough time over there. They lost a heartbreak over there by one. We'll see what Bradley can do against the Bulldogs. A
lot of pressure. The Braves work by it. Luke lost the ball, but he was fouled from behind by Johnson with 57 seconds to play.
Luke isn't necessarily the guy you want bringing the ball up, breaking your pressure, but he got the job done.
And they started to pass the ball around. You were mentioning earlier that the Braves were trying to dribble too much against that press. They worked it around in the air, and it did them some good. Luke with 16 points, and that ties his career high, so he can set a new standard for himself if he hits the second free throw, and he can also put the Braves up by 12. He does not. Tulsa down by 11 points. Moss with the three-pointer. That was way off the mark. Now they're throwing him up with guys in their faces. Brian Riley steals it away. Moss again. And this three-pointer goes down, and Tulsa wants another timeout. 85-77. They pulled within 8 with 38 seconds to go, and those three-pointers can pull you back in a hurry.
Can you save money and get better control with Eradicane? Ask John Hoffman.
I switched from Lasso and saved about $3 an acre, and I got great control.
You'll get better grass control at a better price than Dual or Lasso, like Bob Olson.
The Eradicane saved me $3.50 an acre and gave me better performance than Lasso.
Let's meet Gene and Nancy Youngquist.
Compared to Dual, Eradicane can save me $3 an acre.
Save money and get guaranteed control with Eradicane.
He is right, you know.
Switch and save with Eradicane.
Your mind is a source of great power. You can think of anything. Think of a number. Like magic, a number comes to mind. Sometimes you will think of numbers that come in sets of three. These are very special numbers. These numbers can win you money. Use them to your advantage.
Winning numbers here so far, 85 for Bradley, 77 for Tulsa, but 38 seconds to play. David Moss hit that three-pointer just before Tulsa called a timeout, and that's what has the Golden Hurricane with an 8. Luke to inbound, against the pressure, gets it to Jones, batted away by Riley. Tulsa's got the ball, goes up with a three-pointer, it's good, it counts, and he was fouled. Oh
score. This could be a four-point play and cut the lead in half. Wow.
You know, one thing that Bailey has to be conscious of is when Tulsa is pressing, you got to get the ball into the hands of either Anthony or Hawk. You know, here you see they got the steal because the ball went to Greg. Brian Riley makes a smart move, taking out the three-point range. Greg's got to stop, not go out here and pressure. Let him shoot the shot, go in and get the rebound so you don't get the foul and the four-point play.
Greg Jones with that foul is out of the ball game with 9 points. That was his fifth. Brian Riley at the line with 32 seconds left. Doesn't hit the free throw. The Braves have the ball. And Hawkins is fouled by Brian Roy. The fans want two shots on the foul. However, Hawkins will be in a bonus. That's five fouls on Brian Roy.
And you'll see the Bradley player of the game step to the line. Percy Hawkins, our North Point video and Plaza video player of the game.
He got the Braves that big lead with his 17 points in the first half. There's a lot of games you could give Hawk the player of the game right there.
I think you could justify doing it just about every game we've done so far this season.
That's Rod Parker checking in for Lloyd, who fouled out.
We also see Coach Albeck put Len Bertolini into the game to combat Tulsa's press, get an extra ball handler in there, take the pressure off Anthony and Hawk, give an extra guy to bring the ball up.
That's 25 for Hawk. An 86-80 lead, but this is the big one because with 29 seconds left, it means that Tulsa needs more than just 2 3-pointers. And Hersey hands the free throw in the clutch. 25 seconds, Brian Riley with Hawk in his face. He got it. 20 seconds to go. It's a four-point game. Ahead to Hawkins, 15 seconds to Paul Wilson. Boy, was he hit. Donald Royster, his fifth foul, and he walks directly to the Tulsa bench, and right now, that's about the smartest thing he could do. Paul Wilson would love a piece of it.
You know, as a player, you can't respect the guy who does this. You know, this is really a Bush League play. He's not attempting at all to go for the ball. He's going for body. And that's really a shame. Someone could get hurt seriously.
So Royster's out of the game with 12 points, and we have a timeout here on the floor. At least what appears to be a timeout. I didn't notice anyone call it. But both teams are huddled in front of their respective benches, and now with 13 seconds left, Wilson will step up to the free throw line. The Braves only on top, 87-83. Obviously a technical call against Royster, who tried to use Wilson like a stepladder. And Paul rims the bucket. He'll get another. And he hits it.
Well, tonight we saw a nice foul, and we saw a not-so-nice foul.
And a not-so-nice look from J.D. Barnett. He's staring holes to the official. 13 seconds left, Bradley by five. Wilson will inbound. They get the ball back, and Bertolini and Brian Riley collide on the play, and who's it against? Well, they call it on Rod Parker. I didn't even see what he did unless he pushed Bertolini into Riley. Right now, anything's possible. There's Jeff Riley. And there's J.D. Barnett. Bertolini at the free throw line, and a lot of confusion out here. Apparently Paul Wilson's left hand is hurting him. And now Anthony Manuel will go to the free throw line. Bertolini thought it was he who was fouled. And everybody's confused. The front end of the 1-1 with 13 seconds to go is good.
You know, I want to take this opportunity to compliment Anthony on a great game. I thought he played very well scoring and also dishing the ball off and controlling the tempo of the game, which we thought was so important. You know, he keeps playing like this, people might forget too fast about the guy who played the point last year.
What was his name?
I can't remember either. See what I mean?
19 points for Anthony Manuel. 10 seconds left of the game. Johnson with the long three-point attempt. 4 seconds, 3 seconds. Bertolini is fouled. Fouled by Jeff Riley. The Braves have scored 90 points against the team that last year allowed only 58 per game. And they will beat the Tulsa Golden Hurricane. And look at Anthony Manuel. Maybe he'll throw the ball up to the roof again today.
He's played 3 outstanding games in a row. Illinois State, Creighton, and this one.
You know, one thing we didn't do, we didn't get a chance to compliment the crowd. You know, it was so loud at times, Mark and Lee, I couldn't even hear you speaking through the mic. Great crowd tonight here in Carver Center.
Moss with the heave, but it won't make any difference. Bradley has beaten Tulsa and beaten them by a 92-83 count. 92 points against the Tulsa Golden Hurricane here at Carver Arena tonight, where the Braves have now won 24 in a row. And Bradley is in a three-way tie with Wichita State and Tulsa atop the Missouri Valley Conference. For Jim Les and Lee Hall, I'm Mark Strauss at Carver Arena. The Braves win it, and we'll see you Saturday when the Braves play great.
Sports, Downstate's television sports leader.